So let's see the sponginess and the juiciness of this. Look at that, it's like a sponge ball, isn't it?
Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shrink. Taste test first. This is very very juicy, very very soft and very delectable. This is nothing but Rasgulla, Rasgulla. This is very popular, people claim from Bengal, people claim it is from Orissa. Now let's leave that apart and prepare some Bengali sponge Rasgulla. This is my favorite Indian sweet dish and I have failed over 30 times to prepare this dish. Yes, over 30 times, that too miserably. I have experienced everything, dry Rasgullas, broken Rasgullas, flat Rasgullas and whatsoever, everything, and I have the perfect solution of everything now, as I have experienced so much. This is the perfect recipe for you all. Let's have a look at the ingredients required for preparing this Bengali sponge Rasgulla.
All we need is some milk, sugar and lemon. Now milk has to be pure cow milk, it has to be full cream and fresh. Don't use homogenized milk or UHT treatment, what they say, or Tetra Pak milks. Don't use that. 1 liter of milk, 2 cups of sugar. Sugar quantity depends upon the quality of milk that you are using and how much henna does the milk gives, and some lemon. So let us start. In a pan, add the milk. In medium flame, stir the milk and keep stirring it occasionally to prevent the burning of milk, as well as if you don't stir it, the malai may separate or cream may separate from the milk, which you don't want to have. And on the side, take out the juice from the lemons and mix it with some water. Now you can see here the milk has started to boil, and this milk is boiled and you can see the cream has also not separated at all. Now I'm going to switch off the flame and wait for about 30 seconds before adding the lemon juice. I have mixed my lemon juice with some water, about 2 to 3 tablespoons of water to about 2 tablespoons of lemon juice or so. Now I'm going to slowly add in this mixture into this milk. Now you can see the milk has started to curdle. You can see the greenish whey is out from the milk. Our chhena is ready. Without any further delay, directly strain this. Here I have a colander lined with the cheesecloth. I'm going to add this mixture. Move this chhena once or twice like this to remove off all the whey out of it. Now add some water. This will not only cool the chhena but will also remove off the lemon sourness. Now try to gather the sides and lightly squeeze it. It might be hot, be very careful with it. Okay, some more of the water to clean. Don't apply too much pressure, lightly. Now hang this chhena for about 30 minutes in a kitchen tap or in your cupboard for about 30 minutes and all the excessive whey will be out from it. Don't try to squeeze much because your chhena might get dry and it will not be good. So here we have about 10 cups of water. I'm going to add 2 cups of sugar to this. You might be thinking that is a lot of sugar syrup in here, but the calculation behind it is that if you have a rasgulla of 1 inch diameter and it will puff up into 2 inches, and then we want another 2 inches for letting it rotate nicely and swim it in sugar syrup nicely. So that is the reason behind getting so much of sugar syrup in here. If you have a smaller cooker, you may use that, and in that you will have to use little less sugar syrup for that. So that is the reason behind it. So let's heat this up and knead our chhena. Here we have our chhena, which is resting for about 30 minutes. I mean hanging for about 30 minutes. Here you can see this is neither dry nor moist. This has to be like this. It is moist but not so dry. So we are going to knead this until it gets smooth for about 3 to 4 minutes. It actually depends upon the quality of milk. Like if you use a toned milk, that will take about a long time, about 15 minutes or so, but this is pure fresh cow milk. This will take about 2 to 3 minutes to gather all. Continue kneading it like this and do like this also in between. You might hear a little sound, chirping sound like of thing here. That is the consistency that we are after. This is not dry, nor moist, nor wet. This has to be like this. If it is dry, your rasgullas will be dry from inside. If it's moist, it might get break or it might get flat in sugar syrup. So continue kneading for about 3 to 4 minutes, and some fattening will come out of it. We don't want to knead further. As soon as the fattening starts leaving this chenna, we have to stop and make the balls and dump it in the sugar syrup. So this has been kneaded well for about 3 to 4 minutes. You can see the consistency. This is not grainy. This is not neither too soft or not too smooth. This has to be like this. I don't want to scare you out from my previous failed attempts, that it all depends upon the kneading process. If you knead it too much, it is going to ruin. If you knead it less, it is going to ruin. So it has to be like this. There should be some pores like this and some graininess, but not too much also. So now let's make smooth balls out of it. So this will make about 8 for me. Here I have my rasgulla balls ready. You can see these are of this size and there are some cracks and grits, but don't worry, these will help in getting them puffed up very nice. So now you can see this water is bubbling really well. I'm going to add this into this. So okay, it's fine, let me add all. Now I'm going to immediately cover it like this itself. You may use any pot with a tight lid, or you can use a big pressure cooker like this. This is a 3.5 liter pressure cooker. I'm not going to cover it, just I'm going to cover it with a lid like this. Set up a timer of about 15 minutes and check it. After about 5 minutes, stir it once and check. I'm going to show you how it looks like after 5 minutes. Make sure the flame is at high for about 2 to 3 minutes. After that, take it to medium high. The water should be continuously bubbling. So it has been about 5 minutes. Don't stir it for the first 5 minutes. You can see they are looking very puffed up and nice. Give it a stir slowly. Cover it again. And after again 5 minutes, we are going to give it a light stir. So it has been about 15 minutes or so and you can see them. They are really puffed up and really nice. What I'm going to do is switch off the flame. And then I'm going to transfer these into a bowl. If you see some spots like you saw just now, like brown spots, don't worry, they are just little sugar dirt that will go. You may clean the sugar syrup, but I was feeling lazy. With some milk. So I have added all my rasgullas in here, and if you stir the rasgullas while cooking too much, then your rasgullas might break, like this one has got little bit, but don't worry about that. We have to wait for about 6 to 7 hours before serving them. Right now they are super soft, they are not holding their shape at all. After 6 to 7 hours they'll get sweet, they'll hold their shape and they'll be perfect and they'll be very nice. So after 7 hours we are going to serve them. Here we have our rasgullas ready to be gobbled up. They are super soft and super nice and super spongy. If you are worrying about the leftover sugar syrup that you will get from this rasgullas, don't worry, the next video is for you. How to use leftover sugar syrup of rasgullas, gulab jamuns, bantuas, jalebis and whatsoever. So let's see the sponginess and the juiciness of this. Look at that, it's like a sponge ball, isn't it? So do try this and let me know how it turned out to be. And yes, don't forget to check out our new website cookingshipping.in and do subscribe for more of Cooking Shipping. Thank you.